friends, welcome back to another episode of Heart to Palate. Now, since the month of Shravan is beginning, and I'm going to share most of my mom's exclusive recipes that she used to definitely make during the month of Shravan, and they are like exclusive flavors. I'm pretty sure you're going to enjoy these recipes. The first recipe I'm going to make is Mugachi Amti, which is sprout curry, Karwar style, with Urda Methi flavor. I hope you enjoy this, and let's get started. I'm going to start the recipe for Mugachi Amti. It's a sprouts curry and it's typically made with methi danas and urad dal, and that's the flavor of it which it gives. I'm going to add small spoon of methi dana and a tablespoonful of urad dal. I'm going to saute that in 1 teaspoonful of oil. And we have to saute until the urad dal becomes pinkish in color. You don't have to burn it. And this I'm going to grind with fresh coconut. Coconut we are not frying. We are just going to use fresh coconut. And I'm going to saute this in small amount of oil. Once it cools down a little bit, then you grind it in a mixer with the fresh coconut. Dal has turned nice pink in color. I'm going to leave it aside to cool it down a little bit, and I'm going to grind it with 1 heapful bowl of fresh coconut. I've used about 3 big bowls of sprouted mung, so I'm going to use 1 full bowl of coconut, fresh coconut, and 1 tablespoon of urad dal, and 1 small teaspoon, like small spoon, of fenugreek seeds that you've seen. You can see the moong has nicely sprouted now. I have made sure that the husks are removed. Not all of them, you have to remove at least as much as possible. I'm going to put it in a pan. Right now I'm not adding any oil or anything. I'm going to add water to this and red chili powder, about 2 teaspoonful I would say. There's no haldi in this recipe. And I'm going to let it boil until it cooks. I'm going to add water. You can see as much as it soaks in, not too much water though. And I'm going to cover it and let it cook. Now you can see the water has reduced and the moong, they're kind of cooked now. You can press it in your finger and see. I'm going to add the coconut and fresh coconut, the fenugreek seeds, and the urad dal that I roasted and had made the paste of it. I'm going to add it to this. Of course, you have to add the salt at this step. I'm going to add a little bit of tamarind paste to this. This amti is a little bit sour and sweet at the same time. Depends how much taste you like of sourness. And also I'm going to add jaggery or gul. I like it a little bit spicy and sweet at the same time, so I add a little bit extra. My mom would always yell at me for adding extra gul. How I wish you could smell the aroma. It's fantastic. Reminds me of childhood. Now this is clarified butter I have taken. I'm warming it right now. I'm going to make tadka for the amti. And it only has a little bit extra hing as compared to normal amount of hing that we use in our food. So I'm adding the hing. And lot of curry leaves. As you can see, this is a tadka now. You can see the splattering of the curry leaves. There's no jeera or rai in this at all, just the hing and ghee, and you're going to add this to your curry. How I wish you could smell this aroma. Nigachi Ampi is ready to be served with garam garam bhat. Hope you enjoyed this Mugachi Ampi recipe. The recipe is in the description box below. And please don't forget to share, like and subscribe Heart to Palate.